about how the U.S. was not succeeding during the 18-year war. The Post and others are comparing it to the leaked documents known as the Pentagon Papers, which showed the U.S. government lied about the U.S. winning in Vietnam. The Special Inspector General for Afghanistan Reconstruction interviewed 600 people. Those interviews were never supposed to be made public. The top U.S. commander in Afghanistan, General Scott Miller, is slated to brief Congress in closed sessions today and tomorrow. Miller is the 17th general to lead U.S. and allied forces in Afghanistan. Since 2001, more than 775,000 U.S. troops have deployed to Afghanistan. Of those, 2,300 were killed and 20,589 were wounded in action, according to the Pentagon. The distortions began in the early stages of the war. Quote, "We didn't have the foggiest notion of what we were undertaking," one key general said. Like his predecessors, the current Secretary of Defense continues with the happy talk that Pentagon reporters and the public have been fed for years, citing progress that doesn't exist.
The bigger story coming out of Afghanistan is this, is that the Afghan security forces have really stepped up. We've seen a marked improvement in their performance when it comes to actions against them.
For nearly 18 years, the Pentagon talking points have remained the same. If there were more suicide bombings in the capital, it was because the Taliban were feeling desperate. If U.S. troops casualties rose, it was because the military was leaving its bases, taking the fight to the Taliban. One top general said in 2008, "Are we losing this war? Absolutely no way. Can the enemy win it? Absolutely no way." The war has cost an enormous sum, nearly $1 trillion. The Post report said it was common at headquarters in Afghanistan and at the Bush and Obama White Houses to favorably distort statistics. Shannon?
All right, Jennifer Griffin, disturbing the Pentagon. Thank you. And breaking news now, we've been monitoring the shooting over in Jersey City. Press conference there now. Authorities, let's listen in.